Hello everyone, this is a video explaining about Test of Grocery Shopping Skills, or TOGS for short. These are the contents for this video. First is the introduction of the TOGS assessment. It is developed by Ketana E. Brown, Melissa Ramfer, and Edna Hamira. The Test of Grocery Shopping Skills is a performance-based assessment that measures how accurately and efficiently clients can locate items from a list that is given within the assessment in a grocery store. It is developed primarily to assess individuals with serious mental illness, as it is also ideal for the use of other populations in which cognitive impairments could interfere with community living skills. Next is the purpose of the TOGS assessment. It is to assess the performance of one's ability to shop in the community. It is also to assess a client's ability to efficiently and effectively locate and select specific items at the lowest price within the natural environment of the grocery store. It is also to examine the effectiveness of training grocery shopping in individuals with schizophrenia. The type of the TOGS assessment is a performance-based measure. It requires the patient to perform a set of movements or tasks that requires the actual performance of the patient.
There are 9 components being assessed in this TOGS assessment.
Next are the indications of this assessment, which are serious mental illness, cognitive impairments, and developmental delays that interfere with community living skills. On the other hand, contraindications, the assessment only assesses one area of community living. It also is used for a limited population and also takes prep work to make sure all items are readily available. And these are the factors that may bias the results. Moving on to the demonstration of the TOGS assessment. These are the tools or equipments needed.
Next is the administration procedure. There are 2 administrations, which are pre-administration and administration continuous.
Firstly, pre-administration. Prior to the testing, the therapist must inform the store management for their approval. Then, the therapist visits the store ahead of time to create the store map. Then, before starting the assessment, the therapist interviews the client to identify anxiety issues in grocery shopping and the client's estimation on their acquired performance skills. Then, the therapist should explain the instructions for grocery shopping to the clients and make sure they understand all the points. Lastly, the clients are given a clipboard, grocery list, a pen, and the timer starts as soon as the client gets the card.
Next is continuous administration. As the client shops for the items on the list, the therapist marks an X on the map for every location in the store the client stops to look for an item. An additional X is added for each additional stop.
An X is marked too each time the client parks the cart or stops to ask for help. The testing is concluded and the timing is stopped when the client goes to the checkout counter. Items may be purchased or put back at their original location. There are 2 different but statistically comparable pre-test and post-test forms that allow practitioners to measure changes in clients' abilities. And the total time to administer is 20 to 30 minutes.
These are the instructions, the TOGS protocol that the therapist needs to read.
Before the testing, the therapist needs to have the client answer these 2 forms, which is grocery anxiety scale and estimation of shopping skills.
Please note that the demonstration video only shows the example for TOGS form 1.
Okay, assalamualaikum puan. So hari ni kita akan buat test of grocery shopping skills assessment ni guna untuk nak uji kebolehan puan beli barang sendiri dekat pasar raya nanti. Okay, first of all, saya akan minta puan jawab dululah questionnaire ni sebelum kita pergi ke pasar raya nanti. Okay puan, ni self-evaluation questionnaire. So saya akan bacakanlah semua konten dalam questionnaire ni. So saya nak puan jawab dengan jujur. Jawapan puan tak semestinya betul, tak semestinya salah. So saya nak puan bagi tahu jawapan berdasarkan apa yang puan rasa sekarang lah. Okay, so scoring dia macam ni je. Nombor 1 untuk not at all, maksudnya tidak sama sekali. Nombor 2, somewhat. Maksudnya mungkin puan rasa macam tu. Nombor 3, moderately so, maksudnya sedang-sedang je. And nombor 4, very much so. So yang pertama, I feel calm. Apa yang puan rasa? Puan rasa tenang ke sekarang? Puan rasa calm ke?
Moderately so.
Sedang-sedang lah kan? Okay. Yang terakhir, I feel confused. Puan rasa confused ke bila nak buat aktiviti ni?
Tidak, susah.
Tidak, okay. Okay, nanti saya akan kira berdasarkan apa yang puan jawab ni. So ada lagi satu assessment. Untuk estimation of shopping skills. Soalan yang pertama untuk estimation of shopping skills ni, how good do you think you will be at finding the correct items on the list? So, puan rasa poor ke, fair, ataupun good, ataupun very good?
Very good.
Very good, okay. Soalan yang kedua, how good do you think you will be at finding the lowest price for the items? On yang kelima, estimate how many minutes it will take for you to find 10 grocery items. Puan rasa berapa lama puan boleh ambil masa untuk beli semua barang?
30 minit.
30 minit, okay.
Next, the therapist has to read the grocery shopping instructions to the participant. After that, give the participant a clipboard with the grocery list.
Okay puan, ini adalah instructions, list of instructions, arahan-arahan, apa yang perlu puan buat bila dah sampai pasar raya nanti. So, arahan yang pertama, you will be given a grocery list of 10 items that you will need to locate and select. So, ada 10 items dalam grocery list ni. Puan boleh tengok, nanti saya bacakan. Okay, seterusnya, you will need to pay close attention to decide what size to purchase. So, puan kena perhatikanlah, puan ambil barang tu betul tak size-nya. And yang ketiga, you will need to purchase the brand that is the lowest cost for the size. Okay, so puan perlulah pilih brand yang harga paling rendah lah. Okay, yang keempat adalah, when finished, take the card for a checkout counter. Bila puan dah habis pilih semua barang, ikut list 10 barang ni, puan boleh pergi ke checkout counter. Yang kelima, I will be with you as you shop and maybe taking notes. Use whatever strategies you use when you do your own shopping to find the items on the list. And I will be unable to answer your questions you have about the items on the list or the products to select. If you want, you may ask others for help. Puan faham ke dengan statement ni? Okay. Yang keenam, I will be timing you. This does not mean you need to rush, but try to not to be stung lah. Yang ketujuh, for participating in the task, you may keep the items that you find. You may only keep items that are on the list. List yang 10 barang ni lah. Okay, puan faham ke?
Faham.
Faham? Okay, kalau puan faham, boleh tak puan terangkan balik kat saya apa yang puan faham daripada instructions ni?
Pertama, saya boleh ambil barang yang betul. Yang kedua, saya boleh ambil saiz yang betul untuk barang itu.
Betul.
Ketiga, saya akan ambil harga yang paling rendah.
Betul.
Yang keempat, saya tak akan membazir masa. Yang terakhir, saya akan gegar bayar bila sudah habis beli barang.
Okay. Okay puan, bagus. Puan ingat semua instructions untuk pergi grocery shopping ni. Okay puan, ni clipboard dengan pen. Puan perlu bawa masuk kedai nanti untuk grocery shopping. Okay puan, ni senarai 10 items yang perlu puan cari. So dalam list ni ada 10 item. Boleh tak puan bacakan untuk saya setiap item dalam list ni?
15 ounce can red kidney beans, 1 pound bag of salad mix, 14 ounce can of powdered cleanser, 1/2 pound ground beef chop, 1 small packet taco seasoning mix.
Okay, bagus. Okay, so puan perlu bawa clipboard dengan pen ni masuk kedai nanti. Seterusnya ada tak yang puan tak faham dalam list ni?
Stewed tomatoes ni apa?
Stewed tomatoes ni, dia saya tak boleh beritahu puan tapi produk ni memang ada dalam kedai tu. Jadi kalau tak ada apa-apa lagi, jom kita pergi ke pasaraya.
This is the store map that the therapist has to prepare before the client went shopping.
Okay puan, kita pun dah sampai. So bila puan ambil bakul je, saya akan mulakan timer ya. Jangan risau, saya akan ikut puan dekat belakang. Tapi saya tak boleh tolong puan tau. Puan boleh minta tolong dekat siapa-siapa dekat pasaraya tu nanti. Kalau tiba-tiba puan rasa buntu kan, saya nak puan fikirkan apa yang puan akan buat kalau puan saya tak dekat situ. Okay? Puan faham tak?
Faham.
Okay, semua benda dah ada kan? Okay, mari kita pergi.
Next is the scoring procedure. For accuracy, add all the scores for each column, then total up all the three columns to get the accuracy scores. For time score, which is the total time taken to complete the task, while redundancy is the actual number of aisles that have been entered by the client, deducted to the exact number of aisles needed to find items. Also, tally the number of times participant asked for help, when unsolicited help was offered, and when the participant parked the car. Next is the interpretation for the TOGS assessment. The possible accuracy scores range from 0 to 30. The higher the scores for accuracy indicates better grocery shopping performance. The lower the redundancy signifies greater efficiency. Next is psychometric properties. For reliability, it has adequate test-retest reliability and excellent inter-rater reliability. For validity, in terms of face validity, functional capacity measures share many characteristics with cognitive assessment methods and therefore have been viewed as ecological or practical cognitive measures. For content validity, it has been determined the various aspects of grocery shopping is proven to be important and yet difficult. Moreover, TOGS has excellent discriminant validity as well as excellent convergent validity. For predictive validity, serious mental illness, P is less than 0.05 and self-report alone couldn't predict real-life shopping skills. The advantages of TOGS assessment, it has significant reliability and validity, it is easy to administer and score, it is detailed in aspects of accuracy, time and redundancy, it measures real-life measures of performance, it allows therapists to observe participants in natural environment, and it is objective and observation-based. The disadvantages, however, measures only one aspect of community living. It is time necessary to travel out into the community. It focuses on a limited population. The prep time has to be done to ensure testing can be completed. The testing is designed for medium-sized grocery stores and not supercenters where more people typically shop. And these are the references for this video. We have come to the end of the video. Thank you for watching!